Hello, Star Wars unboxing fans. Welcome to another episode of Darth Tuba's Star Wars Unboxing Show. I'm your host, Darth Tuba. And look at all this. If you watched last week's episode, you know that a whole another slew of boxes came in, and I just received two more notifications of things that are coming in the mail. This fast and furious. So it occurs to me, and I've just been like kind of giving my own commentary on this, the whole new way of collecting is now all about online sales and pre-orders and shipping and waiting for all this stuff to come. And it all started and really hit high gear just as the pandemic also kicked into high gear, which means that we really didn't know what a normal way of doing this was going to be like. Now what we're seeing is that things that I kept a whole chart, and if I see that something is scheduled to be delivered May of 2023, sometimes I'm getting that might be one of these you see right here. There are things that I thought were going to be a year off that are coming a week later. Now, I know that up until about a year to 6 months ago, that wasn't the case. Everything was just kind of, you just expected it. It was going to take 6 months longer than they said. And if it says it's coming in a year, it might come in like 18 months. Or if it says it's coming in 6 months, it might come in a year. So you just expected that, you know. It's frustrating to some degree, because the other part of this coin that we don't talk about, speaking of coin, is the fact that they don't charge you, most of these companies, until they receive the item and ship it. Makes sense, right? Well, you know, at least the big box, that's how it works with the bigger box retailers. Well, you know, that also kind of can be a little bit of a sting on your wallet when if you ordered something like 90 items individually over the course of a year and they all show up at once, I mean, it could be a little daunting for your credit card or however you pay. So, you know, just new ways of collecting. It has forced many of us to, you know, rethink how we want to do this. I mean, I've said it before on this channel. I am like shifting my collecting. I have, starting to phase certain things out, and some of the things I'm phasing out might even be things you see on these more recent items. Black Series, for instance, I'm starting to feel like a kind of a noose around my neck when it comes to Black Series. I'll never feel that way about the Vintage Collection. I'll never feel that way about 3¾-inch figures. I like those. They take up less room. They are a nostalgic thing for me, which is why a lot of people collect anyway. So, but the Black Series, as much as I love the coolness of the items and the figures, you know, let's see what we have here, and let's see, you know, there are four items here. There's a few other items in it I'll show in a future episode, and I'll be very curious to see how that works. So, oh, there it is. Okay, just making sure I had my little cutter here. All right, let's start with. I was gently unboxed from the bottom. Just a little bit easier. Just do it gently. Don't go with a too deep of a thing, because you might end up scratching the bottom of the card, which is what I would have done had I done this. Case in point. A figure that I thought was not going to arrive for months. There it is. Obi-Wan. Wandering Jedi. Oh, so cool. VC 245. 245. Hey, old folks, remember when 92 figures seemed like a lot? 245 of just the Vintage Collection. Look behind me. Those are all like Saga Collection and Clone Wars and, you know, things that came out kind of between the episode three, Revenge of the Sith and episode 7. That's just that, and there's some more lined up over there. Crazy stuff. But there he is. Obi-Wan comes with Lola, comes with two Lolas, and it comes with two types of lightsabers, one ignited and one that you can just attach the hilt. And it comes with a blaster. Obi-Wan with a blaster. So uncivilized. So, I believe, whoop, Obi-Wan fell. Again, they've just been one in a box. I mean, I know that boxes can be, you know, recyclable and stuff like that, but I still think that, you know, if you're opening up, selling figures. Ooh, wow. We got an Entertainment Earth catalog. I'm actually excited about this. How often do we get catalogs, you know? Interesting little thing here. Place an order. place an order, at least $69 worth of merchandise, excluding shipping and tax, and enter your source code locating at the green offer box. And you will not only ship your order free, we'll also send you a free Star Wars Black Series figure. I was just telling you, like, I think I might be done with Black Series. They want to send me a free Black Series figure. Now, they're not telling us which Black Series figure, so it could be anything, but still, I'll remember this. Maybe, you know, if I do another set of orders, how long is this good till? Offer expires August 31st. It, at the time of this recording, it is August 17th. So I would have about a week, or I have about 10 days, and what is that, like 2 weeks? I don't know. Is there anything, any big new pre-orders coming out? Of course, some people would offer to say, if you cancel an order, and then if it's stuff that they have in stock, or have unlimited pre-order, and then cast the order again, then you can take advantage of that deal. But I stress to warn everybody, there are a lot. I just received a cancellation order for the Emperor's Royal Guard VC-45. So they're a VC figure, so who knows? All right, who do we got? Oh, we got the New Republic Security Droid. New Republic Security Droid. I believe these were featured. It says, let's see. The New Republic used these security droids for protection and combat, including aboard high-security correctional transports, like the one the Mandalorian boarded in an effort to rescue the prisoner, I guess, Quinn? I can't remember his name. So, this one, it looks like he's pretty much just a droid with a blaster, so he's coming out of the package. This is one of those, now, if they sent me one of these, I would love to have a few. They're like, I wish they would say, is it going to be a troop builder? Like, would I get a Rebel Trooper? Would I get a Mandalorian? Would I get a Stormtrooper, Clone Trooper, Death Trooper? You know, I'd consider that free figure deal if I could have that. As I said, I love, oh, you know, I don't know if I ever noticed this, but I'm going to just mention it right here. I wanted to say, kind of shout out to Hasbro for including the original Rebel Blaster. You can always tell the Rebel Blaster by that silver tip on the end. I didn't notice that in the film. I mean, I'm sure, I know there are people who, you know, go through crazy, you know, they go through each episode like with a fine tooth comb trying to pick out any little Easter eggs, but the droid hands actually hold the weapon very well. There it is with his anvil shaped head. So cool. Oh, look at his feet. His feet are packaged. I know it won't pass the stand test like that. All right, let me get my boxes set up here. So, does he pass the stand test? Yes, he does, even with a little wobble. All right, very good. New Republic Security Droid. Okay, number three. So, again, I like Black Series. Don't get me wrong. I enjoy Black Series. I don't think I would get rid of all of them, but I'd probably end up with some kind of a, you know, limited amount. Ooh, I can already tell by the back of the box that we're going to be getting a retro. Okay, we've got Reva, the retro collection Reva. Again, with the, you know, distressed side. And I believe that since the first wave of the original Star Wars retro figures that they did in Target or Walmart, those figures had the exact same looking card back, you know, card distress, the exact same looking scuffs and everything, whereas I think since then they've made multiple types. Maybe it's just two, but they've made multiple types. I'll have to compare. But so great. Just such a cool, even though they are going for, you know, less detail, 1970s, you know, figure style, you know, I can see that there are just certain things that they just had to improve upon. I love the weapon. I love it how it has that vintage style. It's got the half circle thing. Just awesome. Just awesome. These are the kind of figures that I do keep these in the box, but if I find them on you know, now that they're becoming more common, if I see one in the store, I will grab it because I just think it's awesome. So, Obi-Wan Kenobi. There we go. Retro figure. Obi-Wan Kenobi. These are figures I thought were going to take months and months. Last one. from the top. Oh my God. Breaking news. They sent two figures. They sent me two figures in one box. Thank you. Oh. Obi-Wan Retro Vader. Obi-Wan Retro Obi-Wan Wandering Jedi. So, oh my God. I am like, I'm in like an 8-year-old kid again. This is so awesome. And I gotta say, I'm liking how they did Vader. They did not just do a carbon copy, you know, or they didn't just take the mold that they have of a vintage retro Vader and redo it. They upped it. They gave him a cloth cape. They gave him a slightly different way, you know, like they gave him like the inner cloak as part of his legs. So that's awesome. They gave him the red eyes. This is a different figure entirely. Thank you, Hasbro. All right, and of course we have Obi-Wan, which is, you know, again, he's got the plain clothes with the cloth cape. These strike me more as like Return of the Jedi style, because, you know, I mean, which is funny because Reva, she strikes me as a New Hope style because of the vinyl cape. But here they went with cloth capes for both, or robes or cloaks. So that's pretty cool. Let me do a little cross comparison between the Obi-Wan Vintage Collection and the Obi-Wan, sorry for the glare, but you can see, obviously, I'm sorry that his robe is in the Retro Collection is closed up, so you can't really see what that is. Again, the Retro figures, if I see them in the store, I will grab one. I will grab them and take them out of the package, because I one thing I'm thinking about doing is that I have a whole series of displays. You can't really see them, they're behind the camera. They're actually a set of, I think, a 30 unit display case. It's about this big, and it has a little sliding glass or plexiglass, and I put all of my original vintage figures in there. Then I have like four more over here that just have random, you know, Power of the Force, Power of the Jedi figures like that. I'm thinking about moving them into other clamshell little display cases, and instead having those not only hold some loose of the retro versions of these figures that I find in the wild, but also some custom ones that I've seen be made and I've picked up along the way, and you've seen if you look on my videos. I want to have them all kind of tucked away in those kind of cases and displayed all together. So we'll see what happens. So Retro Vader, Retro Obi-Wan, Retro Reva, VC Obi-Wan, and Security Droid Black Series. I am very excited about this opening because it was four out of the there were five items and not four, and four out of the five were Vintage Collection or Retro Collection, which are my favorites. So that'll do it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching, guys. Like, subscribe, hit the notification. Check me out on Instagram and Twitter. Spread the word about the channel. I'm not aiming to become like an influencer. I'm just wanting to share my love of Star Wars with anyone who wants it. So spread the word. Thank you so much for watching. Until next time, may the Force and the toys be with you.